We are joined by Ethan Waugh, the 49ers Director of College Scouting. Ethan, when watching Javon Kinlaw's film at South Carolina, in your mind, what stood off the tape? What was it about him? 14, we have to have him.
Well, the thing that we noticed right away was obviously his length and his size. And then not only that, but the physicality with which he plays. And then really kind of most interesting for a guy of his size and length is how well he plays away from the line of scrimmage, how well he hustles and pursues the football, whether it's on pass, screen pass, run, down the field. He's made some amazing plays down the field in chase this year.
How does Javon's talent complement the 49ers already host a first round talent on that D-line?
Well, I think it complements it very well. Obviously, with he and Eric Armstead, you have kind of the twin tower effect again, and he gives us a great kind of a run stopper up the middle. So on run downs, he's going to be really effective in there. He's going to cause problems with that length. And then on passing downs, if it's when he and Eric both go inside, they're going to push the pocket, affect that quarterback, and then have Nick and D Ford to clean up on the outside.
It sounds good to me already. I'm already ready to hit the field.
Yeah.
So you guys preach a lot about the culture of the 49ers locker room. Mm-hmm. And just from what you've learned through this pre-draft process, Javon has a very unique background. The story from homelessness to the NFL. What is it about his story and him as a person that you believe makes him a great teammate?
Well, I think you hit the nail on the head with our locker room. One, it's a great group of diverse guys, diverse personalities that kind of come together. They accept people from all kind of different backgrounds. And Javon's background is, like you said, is unique. And so he's been very open about it. But the thing that he brings is that perseverance and the resiliency to kind of overcome things in your life or in your career. And I think those things really pay off, and they're respected by your peers in the locker room, and they're going to pay off not only later in life, but also on the field.
With the effects of the COVID-19 pandemic, did it become a challenge for you or your team to scout many of these players? How did your scouting department kind of manage to adjust to this unexpected change just months before the draft?
Sure. Well, it was really interesting. One is we've got a great college scouting staff. They're very aggressive. So we had talked either in person, at an all-star game, on the phone, an interview at the school with every player on our board before the combine. So before the COVID-19 became a serious issue across the country. So really a lot of our background work was done. And then that also makes that first Zoom or that first FaceTime with those guys after the combine much easier. It takes away that awkwardness. So one, we were a step ahead of the game. You know, most of the video had already been been scoured over. We've decided on the players that we liked, and it's just kind of refining from that point on. So our guys have been fantastic. The one piece that we really miss this spring is kind of the full complement of athletic data and medical data on some of these players. But we've kind of tried to find ways around that. We've improvised, and I think we have a pretty good system. And then the other thing is it's really brought our group closer together. So even though we're in the building with the coaches and scouts, there's a lot of separate meetings going on, but this time we're kind of all in the same room, so to speak, and everybody has a voice, and we've gotten a lot closer through this process.
So you and your team are also on one of these mini screens. We were talking to John Lynch about the different conversations and different screens going on during the draft. You and your team are there as well. How was that, your first virtual draft, communicating with everybody through essentially Zoom? And it's kind of bizarre when you think about it, putting in a pick, everyone's not together. How was that experience for you?
Well, the one thing is it is a little bit different just from the technique you send the pick in and how John and Kyle can communicate with the scouts and kind of make sure everything's in order at the last minute. But then in the end, it's really just a bunch of scouts sitting around a table kind of talking about the players as they're picked. So in a lot of ways, it's very similar, but just some technological tweaks.
It's such a relief that it's been a seamless process so far. Ethan, we appreciate your time. We know you've got stuff to do. The draft isn't even nearly over, so we'll let you get back to work. But thanks so much, and let's catch up sometime.
All right, you bet. Thanks for having me.